After rising to fame as a 13-year-old chorister, four decades later, Anna Jones has found an unusual duet partner for his latest album. Yes, technology is a wonderful thing. He's singing with himself, but in different time zones. Yes?
Well, you can make it work. Yeah. Because the young Alid, beautiful voice, the older, I won't say old. The older Alid, lovely voice too. So he's released a special collaboration to celebrate 40 years in music. Take a look. Alid, morning.
Good morning.
The reason I've just gone, ooh, so we were talking about Eric Cantona.
<you too. laughs>
Eric Cantona, we were talking about him because he's entering. And
you're going to duet with him next.
Are you?
No, fabulous. Actually, if he's coming to the music, I'm going to sign for Man United.
But you've come on. Well, you could do it.
Yeah.
It's a crossover. The range of. Imagine if you two had did a duet.
He's very low, isn't he? Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow. I thought my voice had broken, but his really has.
Did you say you could still sing as high as you used
to? Yeah, I can still sing countertenor. That's the weird thing, you know, when you go into the studio to do something like this, and you did say the wonder of technology, and it really is. You know, the boy part of this was recorded 1983 or 84. And when I went into the studio and sang as old Alid. It's little Alid and big Alid. That's how we could differentiate. The feeling, the emotion, everything I did as a kid instinctively was there as an adult. And when I sing together, it's identical. It's really weird.
It sounds like such a weird sentence, when I sing together.
Yeah. Well, no one's ever done it. And I suppose the person that could have done it would be Michael Jackson or Stevie Wonder or someone like that who'd been singing for years and years. But no, it was world history, really.
Is your voice better now? Or was it better then? And you're not allowed to say different.
It was better then, of course it was. You know, little Alid was, yeah, he had a great innings, 4 years, 16 albums, you know, so, yeah, it was an amazing, amazing time. And to be able to relive it with this album is fantastic. You know, my mum and dad have got a room. It's not a shrine or anything like that. Believe me, it's not. It's drawers with loads of rubbish in it. And they had these, like, shirts, multicoloured shirts, like a green one, a yellow one, and bow ties to match. We're thinking the 80s,
nice.
OK? You're looking at me as if to say, really?
Yes, no, you did.
It's all good.
Really? Yeah. And I said, where are these from? And it was from a series I'd forgotten I did, and that's where the music came from. So, you know, it's such a weird mix. Nowadays, you'd never get away with it. It's like Bright Eyes, Sailing and Panis Angelicus. So every genre of music, really.
Alid, if you were able, through the wonders of technology, not only to do the voices separated by time, but if you're able to walk across that bridge we saw you on a moment ago, and there's your younger self walking towards you.
I'd retire. Weird, Charlie.
What words of wisdom would wise old Alid say to the young fella?
The young fella was wise enough.
Was he?
Yeah. Do you know what? As a kid, I just had fun in everything I do, and I try to do the same now. You know, you said in the introduction, 40 years. It doesn't feel like it, you know. It still feels exciting. This is album number 43 for me in my life, and I still get excited about an album.
So does that mean you are a wise head on old young shoulders?
In a way, I had
to
be.
You had to grow up
Yeah, because I was always mixing with adults.
You miss out on stuff, do you think?
No, the only thing I missed out on was swimming, because every time I swam, I got cold, which is no good when you're a singer. So, no, you know, I might have been singing in Hollywood in the weekend, but come Monday morning, I was on... You know, in double maths in David Hughes Comprehensive School.
What were your mates like with you? Because I think it might have been quite tricky because you had this beautiful angelic voice.
Thank you.
Still do. There you go.
I'll save again.
There you go. But this beautiful angelic voice. Actually, you could imagine someone would take the mickey out of you.
Oh, yeah, there were younger ones that always sang Walking in the Air and stuff. But, hey, listen, you know, I was getting to travel the world and live a fantastic double life. So I was happy. I could take that, really. So, yeah, it was fun.
What's the most unusual circumstance you've been in where someone has said, "Oh, go on, Alid, give us a tune"?
Oh, it happens daily.
Like, what, but has that been a particularly inappropriate place?
Always,
no, not really. Occasionally, I laugh it off. You know, I can sing that high, so you know, I can give a Walking in the Air. You know, listen, I've lived with it all my life, and it's a great song. It's a great cartoon, so it's not a problem, really. You know, honestly.
I'm thinking of that thing as like a GP's waiting room or something.
Oh, all the time.
Really?
Yeah, everywhere. Literally everywhere. Buses, underground is dodgy as you know what, yeah.
Why?
Oh, because you're stuck there. So,
yeah, you can't get out.
Suddenly one person sings. My highlight of my life was in Highbury, watching my beloved Arsenal, where I was 18 years old when the North Bank started singing, Alla Jones, Alla Jones, you're not singing anymore. That was it. The guy would go to heaven. It was.
That is absolutely perfect, though, isn't it?
Yeah.
The one song that on this album, you said it has to be on.
I would have probably said something like Ave Maria or Panis Angelicus, stuff that I've sung all my life, really, the music that, you know, some say I probably haven't progressed, but they're great pieces of music. And to be able to put a different spin on them with Little Aled has been, you know, a real blessing, really. So, yeah, it's an exciting time, you know.
Lots
of firsts. The album's the first, and then I've got the biggest tour I've ever done in my life coming up next year, which I'm a bit scared of because it's only me on stage, but, you know, doing something I'm not used to doing.
And will Little Aled be in the background?
He'll be in the background, probably. Lots of stories about him. I'm singing a bit, but it's not a singing tour. It's just me telling the stories that I've kind of never said before with lots of embarrassing photos like you've got on the wall here. Do you know, I was gutted about that photo, but I don't know who did it, but I love them to pieces because I had a huge spot because I was turning into adolescence on my chin. And it was before the days of being able to take it out. And I think I watched somebody just put makeup on the photo. And thank you.
Lovely to see you this morning. Thank you so much.
Oh, it's a pleasure to come on. Lovely to see you.
Aled's new album, One Voice, Full Circle, is out next Friday. You're watching Breakfast. It's 8:59.